So good morning. I am your guest lecturer. Okay. So I am John Raymond B. Salazar. I am a colleague of Ms. Angelica Sanjego. We both graduated from Ateneo de Naga University, and I am currently studying my MS Biology program at University of Santo Tomas, Manila. Okay. So photosynthesis, right? So this was discussed to you way back in elementary. Right, if I'm not mistaken. Ano? So, paulit-ulit na siya sa inyong tinuro, di ba? The very basic stuff way back in elementary. Then you were overwhelmed when you enter high school, specifically senior high, because you encountered the light and dark reaction, the mechanism, the redox reactions involved in photosynthesis. Okay, tama ba? Na-overwhelmed? At the elementary level, your science teacher showed to you a diagram of the very basic concept of photosynthesis. Then come high school, you encountered light reaction, dark reaction, Calvin cycle, the different photosystems, diba? Kaya during high school, after learning what is photosynthesis, somehow you unlearned it because it is too difficult to comprehend. All right? So if you still remember it today, then good for you. But if you do not remember it, I totally understand. Okay? So what I am going to do is to refresh your memory about the concepts, open up some trauma, probably, of learning photosynthesis. All right, so let's start. So we begin with definition. So photosynthesis is the process in which light energy is converted to chemical energy in the form of sugars. So the process is driven by light energy. The light is the source of energy. Okay, and the reactants, or the ingredients in this case, are the carbon dioxides and water, right? So using light serves as the fuel to convert water and carbon dioxide into glucose. Okay, and the byproduct of the reaction of photosynthesis is oxygen. Okay, ayan. So byproduct lang po ang oxygen. Yung pinaka ginagamit talaga ng mga halaman ay yung glucose. Diba? Kaya linalabas ng mga plants ang oxygen kasi hindi nila yun kailangan. Okay. So, madami siyang nagagawang oxygen, and the excess oxygen is given off by plants as a waste material. Okay. Yung waste ng mga plants, ini-inhale natin. Ano? So, quite ironic. Diba? Yung hindi kailangan ng plants, kailangan natin, which is the oxygen. Yung hindi natin kailangan na carbon dioxide, okay, na ini-exhale natin, yun naman ang kailangan ng plants. So, plants, animals, and other organisms that excrete carbon dioxide, they both need each other. Ano? Yung dumi na para sa'yo, napapakinabangan pala ng ibang organismo. Ano po? Now, the goal of this lecture is, again, to refresh. Ano? So, at least, the definition, the reactants, the fuel that drives the process, na-refresh na natin. Ano? Doon na tayo sa mas complicated na mga bagay-bagay. The light reaction and the dark reaction. And, syempre, redox reaction. Alright, I hope that you are still familiar with your inorganic chemistry. So, anyway, hindi naman masyadong mahirap ito, ano? So, this is a very basic stuff. Okay, we have redox reaction. So, photosynthesis, the chemical equation for photosynthesis is a classic example of a redox reaction. But before we go to that, let us have a review of what is a redox reaction. Now, I want you to study this diagram of redox reaction here. itong merong A plus B is equals to A plus B din naman. No? Pero ano yung pagkakaiba? Yung reactants, walang charges, ano? Pero yung products nila, may mga charges na. Naging ions. Okay? So, in a redox reaction, ganyan yung nangyayari. Okay? So, redox reaction is just a short term for reduction oxidation reaction. Okay? So, all the redox reactions can be broken down into two different processes or two components. Okay? So, we have the substance getting reduced in a chemical reaction, which is known as the oxidizing agent. Okay. Yung substance na nare-reduce, ang tawag natin sa kanila ay oxidizing agent. Okay. So, in this case, alin kaya dito ang oxidizing agent? Is it A or B? Alin dito yung nare-reduce? Okay. Alin yung nag-decrease ang oxidation number? So, syempre, yung letter B, ano? Letter B is the oxidizing agent. Okay? While the substance that is getting oxidized is known as the reducing agent. Okay? So, reducing agent. Okay? The oxidized. So, yung nag-undergo ng oxidation. So, in this example, we have letter A. O, huwag malilito. Ano po? Kapag sinabi nating reducing agent, 'di ba? Ito lang tandaan nyo, reduce. Okay, ibig sabihin nabawasan ng electron. Pasimplihin na lang natin, nagkaroon ng loss of electron. And kapag nagkakaroon ng loss of electron, ang isang element, ang isang atom ay nagiging mas positively charged. Okay? Nagiging positively charged. Nabawasan siya pero naging positively charged. Ano? Nabawasan kasi yung negatively charged particle or the electron. Kapag nagbawas tayo ng electron, mas nagiging positively charged ang isang atom. Okay? Doon naman sa reduction, ano? Okay, itong nag-undergo ng reduction, nadagdagan siya ng electron. Okay? So, nadagdagan siya ng electron, which means mas naging negatively charged yung particle na yun. Alright? So, sana hindi kayo dun nalito or wala. Pero you can always pause the video, take some time to absorb the information or i-trace back nyo na lang yung sinabi ko kung just in case nalito kayo. Ano po? Now, let's go here in the chemical equation of photosynthesis. So as you can see here, the carbon dioxide undergoes a reduction, and the water undergoes oxidation. So ito lang naman ang kailangan nating tandaan. Alin sa mga reactants ang oxidizing agent, alin ang reducing agent. Alright. So, itatanong yan sa inyo ni Angelica sa quiz nyo probably. Which of the following reactants is the reducing agent? Or rather, which of the following reactants is the oxidizing agent? Alright. Now, let's move on to the next slide. I hope that you are now familiar with redox reaction. Okay, so in this slide, we have the overview diagram of what is happening during photosynthesis. So there are two processes. We have the light-dependent reaction or the light reaction, and we have the light-independent reaction or the dark reaction. So, as you can see here, during the light reaction, we need the radiance of the sun. Okay? We need it to fuel the machinery to create the materials which are necessary for the dark reaction. Okay? Oh, merong light reaction para makagawa ng mga components or ng mga materials na kakailanganin para sa dark reaction. Okay? So, ayan. So, dito sa diagram na to, makikita nyo na yung oxygen molecules, nagagawa siya, namamanufacture siya during the light reaction. While sugar is produced during the dark reaction. Okay? So, just an overview, ano? It is not yet overwhelming. Okay? So, ayan. In light reaction, what is needed is only water and light. But during dark reaction, ayan, kinakailangan na meron tayong carbon dioxide. Okay. So, sige. Sa next slide na tayo, mas papaliwanag ko ng maayos kung ano yung light reaction and ano yung dark reaction. So, in this slide, let us have the overview of the light reaction. Okay, first, we have to know what are the components of the light reaction, what are the products, and where does light reaction take place in the plant cell. So, let me ask you this question. So, what is the organelle which contains the chlorophyll, the green pigment? Okay? So, parang Dora lang, ano, tinatanong ko kayo kung ano ang organelle na ito. Okay? So, that is chloroplasts. Okay, so, the chloroplasts contains the green pigment, which is the chlorophyll. Now, inside the chloroplasts, there are what we refer as thylakoids. Okay? So, the thylakoids specifically, these are the parts within the chloroplasts that contain the chlorophyll. So, as you can see here, the green stack of tubular-shaped discs, okay, or simply the stack of discs in this diagram, this is the stacks of thylakoid. So, yung mga pinagpatong-patong na stacks ng thylakoid, ang tawag natin dito ay granum. Okay? Yung granum, kapag madami yung stacks ng thylakoid na nasa loob ng chloroplast. Ang plural ng granum ay grana. So, I hope naalala nyo na yung structure ng chloroplasts. So, sa loob ng chloroplast, may mga thylakoids. Ang shape niya ay discs. A disc-like shape. Ano? Ngayon, pag pinagpatong-patong natin yung mga thylakoid, meron na tayong granum. So, syempre, madami yung granum sa loob, kaya tatawagin natin siyang grana. Alright. Now, what are the reactants? So, we have water. Okay, so, water will be the source of hydrogen atoms. Okay? Then, we have the sunlight. So, the sunlight is converted, the energy from the sunlight, solar energy, rather, is converted into a chemical energy using the chlorophyll that the thylakoids have. Okay? So, here, no? Ang purpose ng light-dependent reaction ay gumawa ng mga materials para sa dark reaction. At yung mga materials na to, ito yung mga materials na kailangan para i-fuel yung dark reaction. So, in simpler terms, the products of light reaction serves as a fuel for the dark reaction. So, tingnan natin, ano? ATP. So I hope that the concepts about ATP is discussed to you by your biology teacher way back in high school. So ATP is an energy currency used by our cells. So para siyang pera ano na ipinapasweldo sa mga organelles para magtrabaho. So syempre, para magtrabaho yung mga organelles natin, kailangan bigyan natin sila ng mga ATP. Okay? So ATP will be the fuel. ATP is the energy currency for the processes to proceed. Then we have NADPH. So NADP alone, wala pa yung H, ano? NADP is in a less excited state, ano? Now, yung hydrogen atoms na galing sa water, kinukuha para i-convert yung NADP into an NADPH. No? It is carrying an extra hydrogen atom and therefore it is in the excited state. Now, the byproduct of the light dependent reaction is the oxygen. So hindi na kailangan ng plants yung oxygen kaya ilalabas niya yon. Ano po? So as you can see here, oxygen exits the chloroplasts. They are no longer needed. Pero as I've said a while ago, hindi na kailangan ng plants pero pinapakinabangan natin yan. No? So we are using the waste of plants for us to live. And vice versa, the carbon dioxide that we exhale, okay, during a respiration process is what plants needed to create sugar. So, in the next slide, what you will encounter is the overwhelming information of photosynthesis. Okay, the processes involved in light reaction and the different organelles, the different parts of the chloroplasts. Ano po? So, sige, let's proceed. Okay, so I hope that you are not overwhelmed by this diagram. Now, I want you to be familiar with the different proteins and carbohydrates embedded in the thylakoid membranes. Okay? Again, let me reiterate this. Light reaction happens in the thylakoid membranes. Right? So as you can see here, this is a bilipid structure, and in the bilipid, we have the different proteins. Particularly, we have the photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. We have plastokinone. We have the plastocyanin. Okay, and many other chemicals involved in the light reaction. But I want you to focus on the photosystems because these two are the primary machinery of a light reaction as well as ATP synthase. Okay? So itong tatlong to, the photosystem 1, photosystem 2, and ATP synthase, this will be the most important proteins embedded in the thylakoid membrane. Now, I want to explain first the photosynthesis. Ay, photosystems rather. Okay. So photosystems, these are large complexes of proteins and pigments. So protein siya at meron din siyang mga pigments. Ano? So as you can see here, we have two photosystems. We have photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. And each of the photosystems have specific pigments. For photosystem 2, we have the P680. Okay? And for the photosystem 1, we have the P700. Okay. The P in that name stands for pigment. And the numerical value indicated in there are the absorbance, the specific absorbance of that pigment. No? So, para hindi kayo malito, yung absorbance ng photosystem 2 is somewhere in 680, and yung photosystem 1 naman, yung absorbance niya ay nasa 700. Ano? So, meron ka sa iba't ibang absorbance rate, ang iba't ibang pigments. Okay. So, ayan na. Na-differentiate na natin yung dalawang photosystem. Now, nagkakaiba yung light absorption nung dalawa. Okay? So, light absorption in photosystem 2, ito yung process. Ano po? When light is absorbed by one of the many pigments in photosystem 2, energy is passed inward. Okay. Until it reaches the reaction center. So, inside the protein, there is a reaction center. There, the energy is transferred to the pigment 680. Okay. Boosting an electron to a high energy level. Okay. I want you to take a closer look at the photosystem 2. As you can see in there, we have an electron. Okay, jumping from the core papunta dun sa PQ, the plastoquinone. That means that that electron is boosted to a high energy level. The high energy level electron is passed to an acceptor molecule and placed with an electron from water. Okay? Then, as a result, magkakaroon ng splitting ng water molecule from the oxygen. Ay, nagkakaroon ng splitting ng oxygen from the water molecule, rather. O, di ba? So, ganun ang nangyayari dito sa process na to. So, inside the thylakoid membrane, we have water molecule. Okay, hindi ko may point dito, I'm using OBS kasi as a recording tool. There is no pointer here, but I want you to look at the water molecule at the leftmost. So, yung water molecule, gagamitin siya ng photosystem 2. Ano po? Ngayon, yung photosystem 2, merong light na papasok dun sa protein. Now, yung light na yon, tatamaan niya yung pigment 680. Yung gagawin ng pigment 680 is i-excite niya yung water molecule. And an electron from that water molecule will be boosted or elevated at ipapasa siya sa PQ or plastoquinone. Apo. So, as a result, nagkaroon ng reaction. Ang nangyari ay yung oxygen molecule mula sa water molecule, kumalas siya dun sa hydrogen. Okay, nagkaroon ng paghihiwalay. No? Meron tayo ditong oxygen molecule and dalawang hydrogen molecule. Alright. Now, then, we have as well hydrogen ions outside the we have hydrogen ions outside the thylakoid membrane. Now it will be utilized by the plastoquinone to transfer the electron to the cytochrome B6F complex. Ano po? Then the cytochrome B6F complex will require again another hydrogen ion outside of the thylakoid membrane. Ano? So the hydrogen ion will be the source of an energy to transfer the electron to the plastocyanin. Okay? So ayun po. Then the plastocyanin will transfer the electron to photosystem 1. Okay, so I hope na hindi pa kayo nalito, ano? Balikan lang natin ulit. Ano po? So photosystem 2 tatanggap siya ng light. Yung light na 'yon i-excite yung water molecule. And as a result, yung electron mula sa water molecule, ibuboost siya, i-elevate, ano, ipapasa sa isang protein na magpa-process at magta-transfer sa kanya sa mga susunod pang chains. Okay? So as you can see here, we have the H2O, we have the water molecule, we have the photosystem 2, and we have the light. As a result, the electron from the H2O will be used, and the oxygen molecule from the water will break away, creating two hydrogen ions and half of the oxygen molecule. All right. Ano po? Then the electron from the photosystem 2 will be passed on to plastoquinone. Now, the task of plastoquinone is to transfer that electron to the cytochrome B6F complex. So, para maipasa ni plastoquinone, kailangan niya ng hydrogen ion sa labas, ano, ng thylakoid membrane. So as you can see here, there is a hydrogen ion that will enter and it will be used by the plastoquinone to transfer it to cytochrome B6F complex. Now, ang task naman ni B6F complex ay ipasa rather yung electron sa plastocyanin. Okay. So, kailangan na naman ng hydrogen ion para mangyari 'yon. Ano po? So, manggagaling yung hydrogen ion sa labas ng thylakoid membrane at 'yun ang gagamitin ni B6F complex para ipasa yung electron kay plastocyanin. And then si plastocyanin naman ipapasa niya ang electron sa photosystem 1. Okay. Ayan. Ang dami-daming ano, no? So, yung pagpapasa-pasa ng electron, itong mga structure na to, ang tawag natin dyan ay electron transport chain. Ano? Pinagpapasa-pasahan yung mga yung electron dito sa chains na ito. From photosystem 2, plastoquinone, B6F complex, plastocyanin, and eventually photosystem 1. Pero syempre, hindi pa tapos dyan yung chain natin. Kasi ngayon, si photosystem 1, kailangan niyang ipasa yung electron na yon sa pyridoxine. All right. Now, para maipasa yon, kailangan ng energy ni photosystem 1. So, mag-aabsorb na naman siya ng light. Ano? Now, this light will strike the P700 pigment. And as a result, it will trigger the electron to be passed on to pyridoxine. And eventually, ipapasa sa pyridoxine NADP reductase. Okay, an enzyme that reduces NADP. Okay. Now, ang mangyayari is yung hydrogen ion ay maidadagdag dun sa NADP. Ano po? So that's it. Now, I want you to focus now on this. The hydrogen ions found inside the thylakoid. Okay. So meron tayong apat na hydrogen ions. All right. Now, these hydrogen ions will be used by the ATP synthase. Ano? Ayan. So, yung mga hydrogen ions na ito, ginagamit siya ng ATP synthase para i-convert yung ADP into an ATP. Okay? So, ayan. So, sana naging malinaw, ano? So, of course, nalito kayo, syempre. Pero again, you can pause the video or pwede nyong ibalik ulit dun sa previous section kung saan dinidiscuss ko yung light reaction, yung mga structures and mechanism ng electron transport chain and paano nagkakaroon ng pagpapasa-pasa ng electron. Okay, the electron transport chain is very important for converting NADP into an NADPH. Po. Then, the hydrogen ions inside the thylakoid, these are used by the ATP synthase to convert ADP into an ATP. Okay? So, ayan. Nakagawa na tayo itong mga materials na kailangan para sa Calvin cycle, which is the NADPH and the ATP. So, I hope hindi kayo nalito dito sa section na to. Or I hope rather na kung sakaling nalito kayo, maintindihan nyo yung concept kapag pinanood nyo ng dalawa or tatlong beses. Hindi talaga may iwasan na malito kayo. Kasi ako man din, nung inaaral ko to, there are some confusions then on my part. All right, so next slide na tayo, which is Calvin cycle. So all right, so this is the last slide of the PowerPoint. So medyo mahaba-haba pa rin tong explanation because a lot of the chemicals here are I think you are unfamiliar with them. But I will try to make things simpler. I will try. Ano? Pero I cannot assure if you can easily absorb it. Ano? Ito yung challenge. Lagi pag nag-aaral ng biology. Yung ang hirap-hirap i-absorb ng napakadaming concepts. But I hope that you will learn a lot from this slide. So, sa dark reaction, wala ng light source. Wala ng source mula sa energy ng sun ano to drive the reaction. Instead, the energy will now come from ATP and NADPH. Alright. Ano po? Now, carbon dioxide this time will be utilized. In light reaction, walang carbon dioxide na involved. Pero in Calvin cycle, there is. Okay. Now, first, papasok ang carbon dioxide sa plant. So, saan siya papasok? Sa stomata, syempre. Ngayon, yung carbon dioxide, magdi-diffuse na siya dun sa chloroplasts until ma-reach niya yung structure na stroma sa loob ng chloroplast. Okay. In the stroma, that is where Calvin cycle is taking place. Now, the first part of the Calvin cycle is referred as carbon fixation. So, papasok yung carbon dioxide. Yung carbon dioxide, as the name suggests, there is one carbon and there are two oxygen molecules. Ngayon, yung one carbon molecule na ito, idadagdag siya sa isang 5-carbon chain. Okay, 5-carbon sugar na tinatawag natin na ribulose 1,5-biphosphate. Oh, medyo mouthful yung term na yun, ano? Pero para matandaan nyo siya ng mabilis, RUBP na lang ang natawag natin sa kanya. Ang importante, alam nyo na ang RUBP, 5-carbon chain siya. Ano? Ngayon, so 5 plus 1, simple, di ba? Well, 6. Nakagawa na tayo ng 6-carbon chain. Ngayon, ang gagawin ay paghihiwalayin natin yung 6-carbon chain into 2 carbon chains. Each of these carbon chains have 3 carbons now. Okay? So, that is carbon fixation. Carbon dioxide, dadagdag sa 5-carbon chain. Nagkaroon tayo ng 6-carbon chain. Yung 6-carbon chain, hatiin natin sa dalawa, na tigtatatlo ang carbon chain. Okay. Sana hindi naguluhan dun sa part na yun. Okay, step 2 is reduction phase. Dito sa reduction phase, papasok ko na si ATP at si NADPH. Ano? So, gagamitin natin yung energy ni ATP, kaya magiging adenosine diphosphate siya pagkatapos ng reduction phase. Ibig sabihin, merong phosphate kay ATP na natanggal. Kaya naging diphosphate na lang siya. So, saan napunta yung phosphate na yun? Siyempre, napunta yun dito sa bagong carbon chain natin, which is the G3P. Okay? And as well as yung NADP, NADPH rather, babalik siya ulit sa NADP. Kasi yung hydrogen, papakinabangan na ulit natin. So, from 3PGA, mako-convert siya into G3P. So, as the name suggests, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, ano? Dati, wala pa namang phosphate yung 3PGA. By the way, yung 3PGA, ang tawag sa kanya ay 3-phosphoglyceric acid. Okay. Ayan. Now, G3P, ano? Yung G3P, ang tawag na sa kanya ay glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Sensya na nag-loading, ang dami-dami ng terminologies na kailangang tandaan. Okay, yun yung nangyayari sa reduction phase. Now, we have the regeneration phase. Now, some of the G3P molecules go to make glucose, while others must be recycled to generate the RUBP acceptor. Okay? So, regeneration requires ATP and involves a complex network of reaction. Okay? So, ayan. Dito sa carbohydrate formation, yung G3P, yung isa sa G3P ay mako-convert into a glucose, magpo-proceed into a glucose. Ano? And yung isang G3P naman ay gagamitin para maging component at para i-recycle into an RUBP. Okay. So, step 3 is the carbohydrate formation. That is very self-explanatory. Ano? Carbohydrate formation. Dito sa step 3, nagkakaroon tayo ng sugar, ng carbohydrate, ng glucose, rather. Dito nagagawa yung glucose. Ano? So, yung isang G3P na convert into a glucose, yung another G3P, yun yung gagamitin para sa paggawa ng RUBP. Kaya ang tawag sa step 4 ay regeneration phase. G3P plus ATP makakagawa ng RUBP. Okay? Ayan. Tapos, syempre, yung RUBP gagamitin na naman para sa carbon fixation. So, siklo lang, ikot-ikot lang. ano? So I hope natandaan nyo yung lesson dito sa Calvin cycle. So ayan. If you have still a lot of questions, you can ask Angelica. I am sure that she will provide handouts. She will provide a lot of supplementary materials for you to learn concepts. Kung naguluhan man kayo dito sa pagpapaliwanag ko, pasensya na. Ano? But you have to make an effort yourself as well for you to understand the concepts. So, ayan. Kasi ganun din naman ako nung nag-aaral ako ng mga ganitong concepts. Sometimes, hindi sufficient yung pagpapaliwanag ng ibang tao. So, yun. Kailangan mo mag-effort mismo na maintindihan yung concept na to. So, without further ado, let's cut it. And I hope that you learn a lot from this discussion. So, thank you.